हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय न्यू वीडियो एजुकेशन कट्टा भटुआ। इफ यू लाइक माय वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकॉन। इट मे गिव यू अ न्यू वीडियो सब्सक्रिप्शन और नोटिफिकेशन। नाउ लेट अस गो थ्रू द न्यू टॉपिक लेटर राइटिंग फॉर 10th स्टैंडर्ड। We go through for letter writing in a different format. While we are going to discuss letter writing, it is one of the important part of your writing skill. Writing skill is one of the skill of language. So remember, if you have a writing skill, you can develop your language study. Remember, so let us go through a letter writing. Before going to start our session, we have to discuss about letter. What do you mean by letter? If you think so, everybody have a different view about the letter. Everybody thinks about differently about the letter formats and letter writing. So if we go through a letter is a written message which can be given to the person for the different perspective. So remember, in another way we can say a letter is the short message sent by the post to the other person. It can be called as a letter. So while we are talking about the letter, nowadays we write letter in a mail format. A mail format is used because nowadays most of the time we are not using written letters. We can send the letters by our mobiles, by our PCs, laptops, we handling Twitter. So format has changed. So nowadays we are using a different format for letter writing. But letter is one of the important part of our life. So we have to discuss it. Now while we are talking about the letter has a two types. First one is a formal letter and second one is a informal letter. So what is mean by formal letter? A formal letter which we use strictly by the forms of rules, it can be a formal letter. And informal letter which we used in a informal way to our relatives, it can be called as a informal letter. Now first of all we will discuss about formal letter. Formal letters are always been followed by the rules. They are strictly used by the rules and they are written in a different perspective. While we are writing letters, most of the time those letters are being used in the offices. So a junior sends letter to his boss, sometimes he complains. There are different ways of writing formal letters. So sometimes we ask for the job application, sometimes we send resume, sometimes we give resignations, so salary demands, slips, etc., etc. There are different ways to write a formal letter. But for our exam perspective, we will go through the format of formal letter. Now, while we are going through a formal letter, we have to discuss it is that we have to write it in a mail format. So remember this thing, that a letter should be written in mail format. So you can write first title may be application, it may be permission, it may be job application, it may be leave letter, whatever it may be, you can write a title. Then if you misjudge, so you can only write a formal letter. Now first of all, the format of formal letter, a first point you have to write is sender's address. sender's address means who the person who is writing the letter is can be called as a sender address. So in exam perspective, if it is given in your question, for example, Rahul Mhatre asking permission from principal, he wants to absent for 10 days for that he is going to marriage of his maternal uncle, so he can write a application to his principal. So here sender's address means is Rahul Mhatre. So Rahul Mhatre, then write a name of Rahul Mhatre, then you can give a comma, then you can write on another line his full address. Then here second point is that you have to write the date. So date is important, so our date format should be there, 21st March, you can give comma 2020 and then full stop. So it can be a second point for you. Then a third point may be receiver's address. Here it means that whom you are sending a letter is a receiver's address. So here the principal of the school, for example, honorable principal Rajendra Madhyamik Vidya Mandir Gorgavle BK, then you can give full stop. So here is the sender's address is the third point. Then next point, it can be depend on the matter of the letter or subject of the letter. So if it is a job application letter, you can have an advertisement. On advertisement, you can have the reference that you have read the news about, or it can be said that you have read the news in Lokmat for the job application which is published in the newspaper. So you can give the reference that whatever you have seen. So for example, your advertisement published in dash dash paper on dated, it may be date. So here you can use the reference also. After that, you can use subject. A subject should be written properly. For example, if you are writing a letter for leave absence, sometime you can applying for the job, application for the post of dash dash dash. If you are complaining, you can write the complaint about broken pipe in our area, whatever it may be, you can use in a proper subject. And after that, you can, the next point may be salutation. So salutation, you can use honorable, you can use dear. Here we cannot use properly dear, for example, because we are using it for the office purpose. So you can use a respected sir, respected madam, etc. Then next, main body of the letter. Here you can use the detailed description why you are writing the letter, what is the purpose behind that. Next, formation of the letter is complimentary clause. So while you are closing your letter, you can write that thank you, you can write thanking you for your detailed prescriptions, you can write complimentary clause here. And last point is name of the person who is writing a letter, then his sign, you can use, you can give if you want email. In this way you can write the formation of the letter of format, formal letter. So here, in this way, you can use the formal letter. In next video, we will go through how actually we write the formal letter detail. So, dear student, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. You can ask here your queries. You can send me message. If you like my video, you can subscribe.